There is a greater darkness than the one we fight. It is the darkness of the soul that has lost its way. The war we fight is not against powers and principalities. It is against chaos and despair. Greater than the death of flesh is the death of hope, the death of dreams. Against this peril we can never surrender. The future is all around us, waiting in moments of transition to be born in moments of revelation. No one knows the shape of that future or where it will take us. We know only that it is always born in pain.
Oh God. Now, I'm away.
Automatic defense procedures initiated.
Got to see it up in the sky. perfectly ordinary American.
Many people die before their time, so that others can live at the cornerstone of civilization.
There's a war out there, old friend. A world war. And it's not about who's got the most bullets. It's about who controls the information. What we see and hear, how we work, what we think. It's all about the information.
You want answers? I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth! You can't handle the truth!
Quite an experience to live in fear. That's what it is. Horror and moral guilt are your friends.
So the truth is, I talk to God all the time. In no offense, but he never mentioned you.
I find your matter of faith disturbing.
The cross commanded to protect those who firmly believe,
and God help us.
If you read the Bible, Mark, you'd know that there won't be another 1,000 years. Right now, we're in the last days, as foretold in the book of Revelation.
The last days? You mean the coming of the apocalypse, right? The rapture.
We only have to look at the signs. There are wars and rumors of wars.
Now, just so the rest of us know how much time is left, when is the rapture supposed to hit exactly? Is it midnight New Year's Eve?
That's right.
Now, is that midnight L.A. time or Eastern Standard Time or what? I mean, what time zone has got in anyway?
I pray for you all.
I'm just afraid that you're going to burn in hell for us.